Hi everybody. As I've been introduced, I work for London Borough of Bexley, so I'm going to talk a little bit about partnership and how we work within our authority and then how we work with some of our external partners as well. So first of all, just looking at the word partnership and what it means, so a little look at the Oxford Dictionary. Partnership is the state of being a partner, and a partner is a person who takes part in an undertaking with others. With shared risk and profit. And I think I would add today and aims as well. And I think when we're looking at partnership working, that's really important. Following the flooding in 2007, the Pitt Review looked at partnership working quite a bit. And in fact, the word partnership appears within the Pitt Review 30 times. As the government's main response to the Pitt Review was the Flood and Water Management Act. It's quite interesting that actually the word partnership doesn't appear in there whatsoever. I'm sure it's just an anomaly, I think. And at least a nice little graph here by the clever folks at Google was just looking at the word partnership over time since 1800s, and it really is quite a modern phenomenon in terms of the number of times the word partnership appears in books. So I think we're all probably aware of the need for partnership, and particularly working within flood risk management. Water doesn't follow political boundaries, and no one team or organisation can actually resolve all the issues that we need to. And I think one of the downfalls of UK legislation for water management and flood risk is that there are so many, there's multifarious organisations involved in the management of it. And I think that adds a greater need for us to work in partnerships so we can try to manage some of those issues that are inherent when you have so many organisations with a stake in this. So it brings together organisations and you can sometimes get access to funding that isn't otherwise available to you. And I think one of the things that comes out of Pitt is actually where you've got all of these organisations all trying to work in different parts of flood risk. Actually, for a member of the public, the ideal in partnership working is it doesn't matter who they contact, they get a seamless service. And it's not a case of, oh no, that's a different type of flood risk, you have to contact somebody else. It'd be nice if it always worked that way. Unfortunately, it doesn't always. So I joined the London Borough of Bexley about 5.5 years ago, and I was really fortunate that actually it was quite a good setup when I already got there. There were already internal partnerships that involved flood risk. And I think the key one involved emergency planning, strategic planning, and engineering services, which is where flood risk sits within our authority. Primarily that was set up for the NI 189 reporting, which is where the government actually used to ask for a lot more information reporting on flood risk than they do now. Now I think we have about 3 measures we report on. Whereas NI 189 brought in a lot more measures, and it meant that you worked with a lot of other people across the council. We don't have that formal structure still in place, but we still work with those people. And I think because we had quite a good grounding where we had had a group that used to meet regularly and talk about these issues, that has carried on. So that's been really positive. I came from the private sector when I joined the council. And I think one of the things that I really noticed, and with every aspect of my job, I think political support was so very important. And it raises your profile amongst your colleagues. And when you're looking at internal partners, actually, if you have political support, you can get on other people's agenda, and that is really important. About a year ago, we were quite fortunate in that we moved to new offices, and they're nice new shiny offices and all open plan, which open plan isn't always the best way to work. But what it has given us the opportunity to do, that the reason we moved to the new offices was it was actually getting rid of a whole load of offices that were across the borough, and so everybody's in the same building, or most teams, and that physical closeness actually makes it a lot easier to work with a lot of teams. And the benefit of actually being able to physically see people and talk to people, you can get on other people's agenda and actually form better partnerships than if you're always just emailing or using the phone. So we work with a wide variety of people across our borough, and some of the teams that I've listed there we have a different level of engagement with, some people we work very closely with. One of the events that we've held quite recently in the last couple of months was a SUDS Facilitation Day, which is something CIRIA helped to put on. And it was actually a really positive day. We had development control, a lot of people from planning, building control, regeneration, all in the same room talking about this change in SUDS legislation. And we had such positive feedback from people within that, saying that we now had a shared language, that we could communicate in the same way because we'd actually seen how other teams across the council dealt with it. And I think that's a really positive experience. My favourite piece of feedback from the day was somebody in development control actually said, oh, I want to be a drainage engineer now. So what kind of success is that? We have various different external partners that we work with. I'm sure lots of you all work with these kind of people. Thames Water, we did used to have regular operational meetings with them, which we're in the process of. Hopefully next month we've got another one lined up. And they were actually really beneficial because instead of all these issues building up and becoming more and more problematic, to be able to have regular operational meetings with them really was very useful. So I'm now going to talk about the South East London Partnership. You might see somebody in the room that's actually on the photograph up there. I was in New York last month, so I didn't actually make the last partnership meeting, but they sent me this photo because they thought I might be missing them. So it brings together four London boroughs, Bexley, Bromley, Lewisham and the Royal Borough of Greenwich. And then we also have the Environment Agency and Thames Water. We don't always get Thames Water attendance, but they are always invited. And then we have representatives from the Southern and the Thames RFCC. I think one of the issues with RFCC engagement, if you're working within a London borough, is you don't have a councillor that's necessarily representing you on it. You're sharing that councillor between boroughs. So this is very useful that we actually, between the four boroughs, we report to both Southern and Thames, and we're able to have councillors from both of those within our partnership. So it's a two-tier system. And we meet quarterly, but we have two meetings because we have an officer meeting and then we also have a councillor meeting which has lead officers at as well. The councillor meeting is chaired by somebody who's our representative on the Southern RFCC. So this is a little photo of when we had a celebration day, which was in 2013, and this was kind of the partnership had been set up since about 2009. And had been having some successes. So we actually had a day at the Thames Barrier. We had a meeting there. We had Lorraine Brown, who's the chair of the Southern RFCC. And we had some people giving us presentations and were a tour of the barrier. And I think that this is actually really important because partnerships are made of people. And being able to create a rapport is really important. And being able to have something like this where you have shared memory, it helps to build rapport and make it a stronger partnership. So I'm just going to talk about the more formal setup and kind of our terms of reference and what we have within there. I'm not going to read through all of this, there's a lot of writing out there, but kind of the key areas of our mission statement are around, you know, what are we there to do? We're there to exchange information, ideas and discuss progress. And as I said, we include the Environment Agency, Thames Water, and then we also invite other risk management authorities where appropriate. And that we have an agreement to openly share our experience and understanding and seek out opportunities for partnership working to give best value. Our objectives, again, quite a lot of them up there, or our purpose as opposed to our objectives. It's all about consistent understanding and being able to have this joint way of working together. We're neighbouring boroughs. Water doesn't follow political boundaries, so it is really important that we have this shared view and we're able to work together in this way. It also gives us a very good opportunity to share learnings and understand perhaps where there are gaps, capacity gaps, within other boroughs and where we can support each other, where there might be more knowledge in one borough and we can actually share that between ourselves. One of the important things in our partnership is the fact that we have the contact with the RFCCs, and that is really, I think, important. It also helps us when we want to actually apply for funding or we're going to put schemes before RFCCs, that we've discussed it with councillors and we've got some representation actually on the committees. These are just my ideas in terms of what I feel is what makes for great partnership working. And I think one of the terms that Max used quite a lot at the end is around trust, and I think that's so important in having that responsibility between you. And I'll just finish it off. In terms of the challenges and opportunities of partnership working, within our South East London Partnership, we have got probably the full range of, or the extremities of, political support. We've got one borough that really doesn't have very good political support, and at Bexley we're very fortunate that we do have good political support, and it makes such a vast difference in terms of what you can get done, and I think that really is an important point. At the moment, you know, we're going through quite an austere period, and it's trying to balance the time that it takes to run a good partnership, to be part of a good partnership, and to be able to commit to it and take responsibility, versus the actual benefits you get from it. It can be quite cumbersome, actually, just purely the logistics of trying to organise partnership meetings when you've got a lot of councillors involved and officers from different boroughs. But it can actually unlock so many opportunities if you can take the time to do it. Team interactions is another thing that can be a real challenge. We've been through it a few times where we actually lose people. What I mean by mourning here is, within any team, if you lose people, you can lose some really key skills and some really people that can give you great advice and things. And it's how you go about, as a partnership, as a team, of going through that process of recognising what you've lost and how you can actually gain that skill back within the partnership. And I think then I've just got some of the opportunities that there are, which I think that we've probably spoken about already, most of them. Unlocking funding is really important. Being able to share that capability across a wider range. And more likely to have a positive impact on plans of all lengths when you're working with people from other boroughs and from RFCCs. Thank you.